champion of the world has arrived. Peace, 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 family. How you all doing? I hope all is well with you. My name is Keisha. I am the owner of Ascendant Astrology, and I am your astrology coach. Today, I'm coming on here to discuss the Taurus full moon total lunar eclipse. Happening on November 8th. I just want to get my notes up here. Your girl be off the hook without her notes. And so I advise everybody to go back to the last video I did 6 months ago. I think I broke down some pretty good talking points in there, and it might give you a refresher as to either what you're continuously completing, closing out indefinitely, or elevating in a new way in some of these themes here. I do think this eclipse is a lot more powerful than we've had even the first time around, because we didn't really get a chance to get Scorpio this time last year, the way Taurus rather, because it was just a regular full moon. But I think everybody was talking about it as if it were, and so I think Taurus is getting ready to show up and show out. On top of all that, Taurus has been in Uranus since 2018. And so Taurus has learned a lot, and it's evolved a lot, and it's really been forced to step into its true authentic self, whatever that is, and be liberated in such a way where, I don't know, I might have to call Taurus the new Bobby Brown. I'm just saying, where y'all at with this? Talk to me, but get out. Taurus gonna be on one. So if we got any Taurus friends and they're a little shaky, please forgive them for they know not what they do. But they might be really going through a major, major, major transformation and kind of being pushed and thrusted into this energy of showing up as who do you want to be? Who are you really without your parents telling you who you are or society telling you who you are? And it could be tough. You know, I don't think it's easy. That's years and years and years of uncovering and sifting through psychological changing, you know. So the full moon, total lunar eclipse in Taurus. We've had several since 2021. There's usually about four eclipses a year. They happen every 6 months or 6 months apart. And full moons are about closure, completions, endings, and they shine a light on things that are not known. We'll have the sun in Scorpio opposite the moon in Taurus, which is about going into the darkness and bringing things to light. This is a north node eclipse, so this is our mission and purpose in this lifetime as a collective to where we're supposed to be moving towards and and fulfilling, if you will, but it's a full moon. And so there's something, maybe even perhaps, of the lower vibrations of Taurus here that we need to cleanse and reformat and reconsider and kind of let go of and change in some kind of way. So the way I've been thinking about this is because Uranus is like the awakener to your true authentic self. And then you have this scorpionic energy opposite Taurus. And it's like it's Venusian ruled. And unfortunately, Venus is currently in Scorpio, which she's not happy there, by the way. And so this is definitely some lower vibrations of Taurian energy that we could be releasing and letting go when it comes to money, what it means to be stable and secure, what it means to be have self-worth and value. We got to rethink what those things are, whether or not they're right for us or not. And so it's like taking a list of societal norms of value, self-worth, self-love, etc. And then what are yours? And then what are your families, right? Your lineage, your bloodline. Taking all of those and kind of mix and matching what absolutely doesn't work and what we need to throw away because it's just not serving us. It's not getting us to. Taurus wants the simple things in life, you know. It wants stability, emotional stability, financial stability, and it wants to be able to take care of its family, right? And so, you know, what's kind of getting in the way of those things when you break down those three columns, right? That's how I've been kind of thinking about this. Yeah. So we're wrapping up something around those themes. I mean, it's going to be different for everybody, but that's kind of like the overall theme I'm seeing here. The sun, I said that already. So yes. And then we have Mercury, Sun, and Venus, all in Scorpio, right? Mercury just went into Scorpio today. I haven't done a live on that. I think it's worth doing. It'll be there today until the 29th of November. And these will, so Mercury, Sun, Venus will square Saturn and Aquarius, the Moon and Taurus and Uranus and the North Node and Taurus. Good golly, Miss Molly. Saturn kind of comes in as the parent and says, "Where's your structure and systems for these new things that you want set up? You know, what have you committed to? Are you mature enough? Are you responsible? How are you showing up as somebody who should be listened to or respected? What's your status?" Ooh, sheesh. You know? And so we could be building on those themes, which still correlates to what we was working on when Venus was in Capricorn all at the beginning of 2021. Ooh. Wow. Where are we at with that process? You know, what was we working on back then that was conducive to the changes that we want to see now? Maybe you got to switch some things around. And maybe it was 2022 and not 2021. It was 2022. What are you working? Where are you at with that process? Ooh, tough. Tough, 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 tough. It's not going to be easy. It's going to bring a lot of pressure because there's a lot of fixed energy here. And when you have fixed energy doesn't want to move. There's nowhere to go. But something's gotta go, right? Oh, how fun. Not like making it fucking complicated, huh? And so you could feel like a burst of energy when this happens, or a release of energy when this happens. It really just depends. Again, everybody's going to experience this in various different ways. This could be political earthquakes, financial earthquakes, behavioral earthquakes. What I find extremely interesting is that the election is happening the same day as this eclipse. Who the fuck planned that? And so there's so many different factors to that I can talk about that aren't good because it's happening in the dark, for one. And two, I feel like it's going to be just like was that last year? No, that was 2021 when Trump got voted out. And I don't know. I think it was because of the pandemic. That's what it was that time. It was the pandemic that kept everybody in the dark, and there weren't a lot of things discussed or whatever. And I feel like it's going to kind of be like that. Well, we have the elections, and everybody's just going to be sitting there like, okay, well, what's going to happen? And we're not going to really know the truth of the incomes and the ins and outs of it until Sagittarius season, because it's happening underneath an eclipse, and eclipses are, they darken out. Everything's going pitch black, right? And it's really not a day to be doing anything. So, some motherfucking ritual they're pulling. I don't care what anybody says. This is really freaky. But with all the transits that are happening right now as we speak, these are all like killer sociopaths, serial killer energies, just like they did with that Jeffrey Dahmer movie, show, whatever you want to call it. Go back and watch them. I know I keep saying this, and people are probably gonna be like, "What the fuck are you talking about, Keisha?" It's the last episode. I don't care what anybody says. They did a ritual in there. It was like Eddie Gein was dying, and at the same time Jeffrey Dahmer was getting fucking baptized, and it was like a full moon. And on, that's a ritual, like how I feel like Beyonce, I don't give up what anybody says, Beyonce put a spell on Jay-Z after he cheated on her. And she did it in a fucking video. She was talking about her period blood. She was like, how I put my menses and my, yeah, what song I'm talking about. Okay. I don't know the top of my head right now. You know what song I'm talking about. That was a ritual. Okay. hey, whatever floats your boat, right? May the best person win. That's all I have to say. I just think it's going to be very interesting to see how that all plays out, especially because Mars will go retrograde on the 31st, which is Halloween. And Mars is our communication. It's our negotiations. It definitely has a lot to do with politics, not everything, but when you're talking about having these kind of discussions back and forth to prove a point. And I mean, it's more Libra-esque, but again, it's Gemini because it's communication. You are giving messages, you are doing a presentation as to why somebody should choose you so that you can make a decision. Gemini is all about making decisions. And so we'll see. We'll see. I mean, at the very least, it could be more so about the past, right? What are they going to be talking about when it comes to how we're moving forward and how we're going to deal with and rebuild from the pandemic? We still, in my personal opinion, have not touched that. Nobody's talking about that. They're still trying to get us to go back to the way things were. I told you back in 2020, we're not going back to normal. So what's really good? We need to have those conversations, right? My sister, I was just talking to my sister yesterday and she told me she caught COVID. I'm like, are you what? Who? Where? And so I wonder if a lot of these kind of issues are going to come back up for review and how well we're doing, where we're at with those, how we're feeling, we could do better, can we do better, and what things we're going to put into place to kind of rectify those issues. It'll be very interesting to see. Taurus rules money, banks, wealth, currency, safety, and security. Okay, the very simplistic things you need to survive. It's a full moon eclipse. We're talking about the end of the year. This is all about last quarter shit. What's the money looking like because of what's going on in the world? Where are the banks at because of what's going on in the world? What's the redistribution of wealth looking like because it's where there's a threat of a recession? Is the currency still top dollar? And the safety and security of those basic needs being met. Can we still provide those basic needs? We'll see. We'll see. Scorpio is big money, hidden money, government money, investments, mortgages, loans, debts, pensions, so the stock market, power, fear, and underground secrets around all of those themes. And so, what secrets are going to come out? What are we going to learn in Sagittarius season from all of this? Again, I think it's going to be very interesting to see how this all plays out. I honestly have nothing nice to say, mostly because I want America to fall secretly, but America's quote unquote doing better than most of these other countries. So you might want to look to other countries to see what they're dealing with. And that'll give you some inkling to what's coming to America. That's another way to look at this. Also, another way to consider this is that if you go back into time when all these same exact transits were playing, which I've done already in previous ones, you can go back to my yearlies. I broke it all down for the years before, and I said some of the themes that are happening that we are definitely seeing repeat itself, to see, what we may or may not expect. But also to consider what kind of control are you going to continue giving into this storyline if we don't see the change? And how are you going to deal with that? Are you going to be, this is definitely red pill, blue pill, depending on how this plays out, right? Say they've found a way to manipulate things in a way to keep us in this lower vibration. It's not the newer Uranus way that want that things should be going, and they still want us to go back to work, and that whole bit there. How are you going to take control over your life? Remember, Saturn is like, how are you being responsible enough to be able to become a boss, right? I mean, To be honest with you, I don't think that we're ready to step up, even if we were. I feel like that's such a negative thing to say, but we have so much work to do. It's not even funny. Mercury opposite Uranus is the truth, just period. So we can see some shocking news around these themes. They can be trying to do some control and blocks towards some of these things. And like I said, Saturn's going to bring in the reality check to it all. This could be issues in relationships around control, jealousy, and manipulation for sure, especially around money. I feel like another way to say that, and I'm probably going to get beat up for this, but this is the rise of divine masculine energy. The queen is dead. Femininity has died with Queen Elizabeth. Just my personal opinion. Who are you going to submit to, right? If a man comes into your life and takes control and does his job when it comes to the bills and the kids and papa, whatever the fuck his job is, right? Are you willing to submit and let him do his job? Are you going to let him protect you? Are you going to let him provide security? Is he somebody that you can follow his lead in those ways? I do think that we'll see a lot more men doing that, wanting to do that, and wanting to step up and speak out more and have more to say and want their word to be taken seriously. I think we can see a lot of mental health and depression around these types of things. I think we're about to learn a lot about how men suffer in silence and nobody's paying attention. They're deadbeats. They don't do their job. And let me be very clear. I understand both sides of the story very well. I'm not confused here. I'm not talking about men who, well, yes, I am. Even men in those positions, because you really have to dig deeper than just the surface level of what people are doing and understand their whole story. You got to go back and walk a mile in their shoes to see where they've come from. And if you're not willing to do that, you're just as much as an asshole as that person, right? When we're all supposed to be here to help uplift each other and one another, but who has the time for that? Make time for it if you want to see real change. Right? Because the only one who can fix us is us, not the government. The government's not going to do that. And so the more we keep pushing away these issues and not wanting to talk about them and brush them away, rest assured you're just as much as a problem as everybody else. That's another Taurus thing, by the way. Because remember, Taurus just wants the simple life. Taurus doesn't give a fuck about your business, your climbing Jacob's ladder, your successful status. Remember the example I gave in my last video was like, can you rub wood together to make fire? Those basic skills to live. Taurus is not about the money, even though it rules money. I think we have a very distorted view about what it means to be successful and to have values and self-worth and self-love. Those come from the basic things. When you have security and somebody loves you for you and not what you're good at. When somebody loves you when you're at your worst, it helps build you up to become successful. And I think we're missing that piece. We're not seeing that part. Somehow it has evaded our values and how we treat one another, which is first to me. And even at the very least, what we should be able to see is that it's not of love because you got bills to pay. Those bills can wait. So what are you willing to sacrifice to build up your family? And that is a woman's job. That's why it's not being done. It's because you're too busy building a corporation. That's not your fucking job. Okay? I'm sorry. I had to say it. If you don't like the delivery, You don't have to watch any porn. I'm okay with that. But somebody has to take on that responsibility, right? Because who's taking care of the children now? And this is why they're out here haywire and we don't have families. We don't want to have these conversations, though. They're very uncomfortable because we are relating our success and how well we do to being able to keep the good fight. You know? Ah, I don't want to have this conversation anymore. It fucking depresses me. It makes me so angry how we don't see that, but. I feel like it doesn't matter which way I say it because that energy is way more dominant than being able to see the simplicity of that. And it's a lot more easier said than done, right? Because we do have bills to pay. The kids do have to go to school and blah, 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 blah. Right? Somebody's got to be brave enough to break the chain. Which, you know, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Anyway, Taurus wants a stable foundation, values to build a life that's meaningful, but Uranus has been shaking things up to make sure what you're building is authentic. Uranus is the awakened rebellious, rebellion. It can stir up chaos and it likes to invoke change. That is what Uranus energy is, the lightning bolt to come in. You never know when or where. Wow. You know, it's very provoking and an instigator, to be quite frank. it reveals where you're out of your own element. So where are you reevaluating your values? So we can feel like we don't want something, but don't know how to separate from it. Boom, didn't I just say that, bitch? The fuck I'm talking about. It's gonna be hard, but you better make a motherfucking decision. You are destroying your own family. The moon is your daily life and the public life. How we feel, how we move through change. And because Taurus is a fixed sign, we may be slow to change, stubborn, or determined to stand our ground, but change is inevitable and it's for your highest good. Nothing is meant to stay the same. And if you don't understand that, then you're out of alignment with universal law. Forget societal. Being in alignment with these dumbass societal norms, that's a better way to say it. You're out of alignment in universal law. Now you're lost two times because you are connecting to a set of values that don't have your best interests at heart, and you're out of alignment with your own damn values and where you come from. That's a double whammy, you know. So the North Node in Taurus is going to show us our new dreams, but the Scorpio energies may have highlighted the fear around what that is. And I don't even think it's fair. I think deep down we know this shit is impossible. We've been looking and staring at what it means to be a business person since 2020 hardcore. Right. And if you think that you're revolving issues around what's stopping you from starting a business or the blockages and things that you're running into has anything to do with the fact that just money and all those other things, it's deeper than that. It's way deeper than that. And that's what Scorpio is trying to tell you. You know, are you just doing it for the hustle? Are you just doing it for the money? What are your family goals and aspirations? And yeah, we all know. Trust me, I'm not trying to be an asshole here. I am pretty sure that every single woman in the whole entire world is extremely clear and aware of why they want to start a business. And of course, nobody wants to do it for the reasons that are suggested. But think about the motivation behind your hunger. when you think about the disparities of having to work a 9 to 5 and how much that pile those the, all those excuses pile up, right? Now, no matter what you say, it's determination. It's survival over determination. You understand what I'm saying? You're not in alignment with the values of the building blocks it takes to build something strong and sturdy. And even more simply put, your masculine energy is null and void. It's not there, right? And so we have to be, and it doesn't have to be a man, okay? For all the fucking people out there who have a problem with that. It's masculine energy in general. Do you have the teachings of that? Do you know what it is to its truest depth, right? Scorpio says go deeper. You might have to stop for a little bit to get hungry. Hungry enough to work through those challenges to build whatever it is you're trying to build. It's a different kind of tempered motivation when you have all of the things that it takes to build a business, which means a team, support, a light heart, not a heavy heart. That means you have to heal. You have to look at the situations in which you're being put in that's forcing you to do this in a way without malice, anger, frustration, that would make you avoid any kind of masculine support or help. I mean, I think I'm trying to bring up scenarios where we can see the disparity in why masculine energy fit is so left out. I'm not trying to beat on anybody or, put anybody down. These are just the facts, right? And if you really took the time to look at it, you would see that. I have two boys. So when you're raising a man and you start to look at all the things that they need and that masculine energy is missing, it becomes really clear. So I'm also speaking as a mother and from personal experience on how important it is to have that energy. And when you don't, look at what you raise and how they come out. They're not on sturdy ground because there's no real teachings there. These are very simple tools that you can see in your life that you need to incorporate in order for it to work out. Heal your wounds around whatever there is that's lack there. Say your prayers to past and present. Show your respects to people who came before you and after you, dead or alive, we got a lot of work to do around these issues. And that's why it's not working. It's not because you don't deserve it or you're not great. You just got to go back to the drawing board. And Scorpio says, go deeper. Go deeper. And again, that's going to show up for a lot of people as to how that comes about and what you need to do. But so we highlighted fear around what you want, the anxiety of what you want. So maybe there are some things we need to let go before we take on this new role, exactly what I was just saying. And a lot of this we are unaware of due to the psychological conditioning. That goes back to the societal norms. This country has done a fabulous job of convincing you that everything you're experiencing right now is true. So again, I'm not trying to beat on anybody. I'm just saying, take a deeper look. The deep programming caused from the pandemic also, ooh, I was having a realization, my damn self, during this from the pandemic because I don't want to go back to work. I had a plan. My plan didn't work out. I don't like what I'm seeing, and I am having a surreal mental health breakdown. And deep inside, I'm like, I refuse to admit that that's why this is happening, because I'm stronger than that. I'm supposed to know better than that. All those things that I was just saying, right? And so now I have to stop and look back and go deeper. I'm going to counseling, bitches. Like, fuck this shit, because I don't miss, okay? My ego talking. Oh, I promise you. I'm when I say these things, I am speaking from personal experience. Because the economic slowdown and the delays with goods and the supply chain issues, shortages and products of products and food, we can definitely see some of that stuff coming back up. So a lot of those fears and anxieties we'll have to revisit anyway. And it's going to be like a few different things. This could be is checking yourself at the door this time to make sure you have the resources to deal with it this time. Don't walk into that darkness without a light. Right? Because you've already been through it. Something has happened already, right? Because we've been working with these energies for since 2018, to be quite fair, right? And so whatever is there, it's already shaking us out of our boots. And now it's going to be revisited, and it's going to be like, well, what are you going to do to get help? Did you put something in place the first time around? Do you have support now? Are there people that you can talk to now? You know what I'm saying? And how are you giving support to others in any way that you can? Did you get some food stored away, water stored away? Can you rub wood together to make fire? I'm being sarcastic, but you understand what I'm saying. Just saying, y'all. There's this tug of war towards the old versus the new way of doing things, and that's what we're also fighting here. And it's not easy. It's gonna feel super, super intense. This can be emotional and financially destabilizing. Taurus rules our money, our resources, and our possessions, and our buying power. And when we don't feel good, or we don't have the money, we don't feel good. And something about that psychologically needs to change. You shouldn't be happy because of what you can buy, and you shouldn't be happy because of the money you have. You should be happy in general, right? So there can be some stress around things, old higher interest rates, having to pay things back sooner than you had anticipated, having less money and spousal support, income due to bills changing, government supports changing. And taxes. Don't let this rattle your cage in a way of, because I don't want to say don't act out your emotions. I don't think that's sending the correct message, because we're human. I mean, just have things in place, pr prepare. I can say more about that, but I think you guys get what I'm saying. And then Venus is the ruler of Taurus, and she's debilitated in Scorpio. So Venus will not be supportive here. She's got nothing for you. She's tired. In fact, she'd rather probably much rather slay you. Just cut it the fuck off. All right? Cut it off. Cut it out. It's gonna be raw. It's gonna hurt. I'm not gonna lie, this shit's gonna hurt, because you're gonna have to look at it. And you got over the next few months to do so, because for one, we're in Scorpio season, and that's just what Scorpio season about is about. Capricorn season is the si season of winter, which correlates with Scorpionic energy. And it's gonna be a cold summer, winter, summer. Venus will oppose Uranus, bringing in changes in fate and relationships, friendships, and a shift in our values. That might sound terrible. I mean, it might happen in terrible ways, Let's just be real, right? You're in a relationship, you think shit's sweet as gold, and you find out the bastard's cheating. You got a best friend who you sat down and had a conversation with, said, "Look, bitch, sometimes I'm going through things. I don't really need much, but I need somebody to talk to this time around, or I don't think I'm gonna make it. This bitch don't fucking show up." That about a motherfucking bitch. Change your circle. You know, Venus is also going to be opposite the moon. She's not in alignment with her emotions. To be quite frank, I think she's a little fucking psychotic here. You know, paranoid and shit, thinking everybody's out to get her. I don't want nothing to do with it. Okay? So we don't know how to nurture. With the Venus and Scorpio. We're coping and having a hard time expressing our feelings. It fucking sucks. This is gonna suck. Like, just period, it's gonna suck. And then Saturn's gonna T-square the Sun and Moon, Venus and Uranus. The good news about this is that Saturn is direct now, so Saturn's a stronger energy. So the teacher's back in the classroom. So we'll start to see the results of what has been going on when all these planets were retrograde. Because I think only now, the only one retrograde now is Neptune. And Mars and Gemini just went, we'll have just gone retrograde. But that's it. Everything else is direct now. So I think that's a really good support, you know. Did I lose my spot? Hold on, guys, because I'm pretty sure I just lost my spot. Yeah, so Saturn's about, are you going to jump back in the game with your plans and goals? Are you going to stay doing the traditional tried and true, or are you going to step out on faith and try something different? I think it's going to be a little bit of both because we do need each other and we do have to live in a world that fucking sucks. And this is the part where I think I've had a conversation about this where I think Gemini plays a bigger role that, you know, we're not talking about more enough. Is that you can't escape living this 3D dimension. And you have to participate in order to win and get into your mission and purpose. All these energies are one and the same. And if you are excluding and or ignoring one of the two, either or, all or whichever or whatnot, then there's something you're holding yourself back from that's like a cog in the wheel. To your bigger goals and dreams. And so it's not about escaping the 3D world as much as, you know, that's in the spiritual community. That's what we all kind of want to do, right? Because this fucking world, it's shitty, it sucks. But I think we have to really stop saying that. You can know it in your heart that there's a bigger purpose and goal. But how do you get through, not over, not under, not around. Because the only way to heal is to go through something. And so you have to accept the world for what it is, separate enough to be able to have a plan, be strong and sturdy in that plan. You cannot be moved. Peace, be still, Know who you are and your worth. Build a team, family of people who can support you on this journey. Yes, I know it's a bitch, but you don't give up on your dream. I don't give a fuck who you are or what you're going through. It's not worth it because you don't know what God has planned for you on the other side of that drama, on the other side of that darkness, on the other side of whatever's not working for you. But you gotta play your part. You'll never know if you don't play your part. And this is how you stay stuck in the past, where you never have gone through anything, experienced anything. You want to look at your Jupiter area of life to get more information on this, in such a way that allows you to have some kind of wisdom. You know, you're just the person who stays in that Gemini every day, daily routine, BS. I'm avoiding, this is all there is. There's nothing more to life. You sit in your room, you smoke your weed, you deal with the people in your four corners, but you can't really enact any of your dreams, your goals, your wishes if you're sitting idle in a place that's quote unquote keeping you safe. Meanwhile, you have no experience. You see what I'm saying? You got to get out there and live your life and do what you do. You got to interact with the assholes. And as soon as you find out they're an asshole, you get to make the decision on whether or not they stay a part of your story or not. Right? And I think that's another misconception that we really need to clear up around these things, you know? Yeah, it's easier said than done. But just because of that, it's hard doesn't mean you get to dismiss it or avoid it. You gotta go through. You gotta go through it, right? So we will blah 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 blah. There will be more setbacks, challenges, and delays. That's basically everything that I just said, right? Jupiter conjunct Neptune and Pisces. I really think that this Jupiter moving back into, I really wished we had more time with this, but I guess it's so powerful. We just, you know, we didn't need it, but I would have loved to have more time with it, to be quite frank, but you know, whatever. I think this energy, this transit is unmatched. It's really fucking dope. I can live here all day, but Jupiter will conjunct Neptune and Pisces again. If you want to go back to my video again that I did in my yearlies to get some more information, in fact, I highly suggest you do to get a refresher of what this is for you. But Jupiter conjunct Neptune and Pisces does bring this energy of high spiritual vibes, prayer, protection, listening to your intuition, pay attention to your dreams. Having a lot of support from other realms, your guides, muses, etc. That's why I was saying pay homage to the people before you and after you. I'm going to use this paragraph right here and put that over when T'Challa went to go see his dad. Remember they did that whole ritual in that movie? And he got a chance to go that I think he was getting initiated then. Super, super important to this transit. So take this time to, if you have an altar, everybody has their own spiritual you know, practices or what have you. It doesn't have to be that deep, okay? But you should have something in place where you can pray and give thanks, be grateful, show gratitude to people, places, and things who have come before you, dead or alive. That's the first thing. And then for yourself, your children, your family, everybody else in the world, there should be some kind of ritual you have for just having gratitude for life in general, right? As much as it sucks, it's so amazing that we get to be here on Earth as actual beings and have a spiritual connection within us that's connected to something higher. I don't know. For me, it's just, I don't know. It amazes me, honestly. The older I get, the more intrigued I am about it. And so, in that way, this Jupiter conjunct Neptune in Pisces is just really a nice touch to this energy. And then Venus will trine Neptune. There could be a sense of soft and ease, but remember, Venus is in Scorpio, and Pisces is almost damn near conducive to that energy. You got this can be a lot of sorrow, loss, pain, shame, embarrassment, release, and letting go. And because it's in Scorpio, Scorpio rules endings, releasing, loss, the end of a situation, burials, transformation, spiritual shifts from the body that release the soul. And Pisces deals with the afterlife and reincarnation and the next realm. So again, we're talking about a massive transformation and connection to the divine here, like no other. Nobody knows love the way Pisces gives love here. You have to remember Neptune is the higher octave of Venus, and even though it's super sad, this is just grief, like any natural process when you're letting go of something. That, I don't know why I just got this picture of, like, because I'm trying to make it more human, more mundane, more 3D, and it's like having some kind of addiction to food and you can't eat that food anymore. You need to have a funeral for that. You have to contend with that release, right? So there should be some kind of rituals and processes. And again, just paying homage and gratitude and being grateful, even though, life sucks, right? But you're here and then you go, right? And so this is definitely giving me like Brother Bear vibes. And you can always go back to that place in that space. That's what the altars are for, or prayer is for, to say, thank you. We may have not had the best time while you was around, and I'm talking to food now. You've given me health issues. You've made me fat and out of shape, but you just tasted so good. And I had to let you go. It should be like that with everything, right? It's a natural process. I'm so fucking dramatic. Oh my God. But it's real. Like, you should do it. Say goodbye and have a ritual for whatever that is because you've learned something from it, right? And you want to acknowledge that. Yeah, so it's crazy because I feel like at the beginning of well, mid 2020, we was all like, yeah, things are gonna get better. And now we're all like, when are things gonna get better? So now we have to address what went wrong. And it all boils down to the company you keep, the resources you have, the people on your team, and proper planning, It just is, It really doesn't have anything to do with the flashy side of it and having the big house and the dope car, and none of those things are important to the goals that you're building, the dreams that you're building, you know? And Pisces does sextile Taurus energy, so this is like going back to the drawing board behind the scenes, having the bigger conversations and meetings at the table, the think tank, all that stuff there, the backroom stuff and the design, and then you give it to Taurus, and Taurus is gonna build it, you know? So we do have that. As bad as it might seem, I still think that we can make it. We can make it work, but you gotta let go of those old, outdated, values and systems and structures you're building off of. So, family, as usual, I've done out talked myself. I love and appreciate every single one of y'all. I hope you found this information helpful. Peace.